What's up, guys? I just got done recording a video about spec and gear for 1.2, and I kind of rambled, and by the time I knew it, it was 22 minutes long, so don't want to sit through that upload. And I don't think you guys want to sit through that, so I'm just going to do this real fast and cut out a lot of the beef that wasn't supposed to be in the video. Alright, so the spec is going to be charge bolt, piercing, endless arrows, double recurve, snare, intensity, wild instincts, expertise, marksman, and then sharpshooting and feral claws, and then oromancy, I'm taking port, teleport, shrug it off, leech, and harden. Shadow play, I'll take overwhelm, drop back, stalker's mark, stealth, toxic shot, shadow smite, and free runner. And the reason this is kind of a weird spec, it looks like, is there's no concussive shot or none of that stuff, and you know, it might be different for you guys, but the reason I'm doing this is because I like, I think this is a more, especially with Inspire Up, the attack speed goes through the roof, and it's a more mobile attack type of thing. Like, I can't just throw all my cooldowns and concussive shot and kill somebody with a charge bolt, you know. It's more sustained DPS. And it's more mobile. Like, I don't ever have to stop to pop Deadeye. I don't have to fucking stop the concussive shot. I can just kite for days. Never have to stop moving. It's all good, you know? Just chilling, just doing random shit like, you know, that. I like this. It's easier to kite things. Especially when you have to deal with these dagger spells and shit in 1.2. You need to stay away from last dudes. You need to stay away from dark runners and stuff. So being more mobile is going to be key. And the snare is really nice. If you get stunned, you can, you know, shrug it off, snare him, and then run away while they're thing. And you can, that'll even break your shackle. So if he shadow smites you, like while you're running, you can attack now instead of like standing there with nothing to do because you're disarmed, you know. Another thing you can do is you pop Stalker's Mark, get on the overwhelm. While I'm lagging out. Shadow smite and then snare. So then that way you get a good opener, a good disarm off the opener, and then a snare so they can't follow you. And that works against like dark runners or anything, even primevals, because if you come on them and disarm them so they can't hit you, and now you got them snared so you can just run away from them and they can't leech you. That's a huge thing when you go in for overwhelms on primevals, is not getting leeched while you do it. So that snare is going to save you from getting leeched or getting jumped on by a dark runner, etc. Alright, so gearing, get the Korean daggers. It just takes an illustrious dagger and some mats that you can find in Sun Gold or Exelok. All the mats for any of these Korean weapons is going to be farmed out of Sun Gold and Exelok. And then for the tier 4 versions, you're going to farm out of the actual library in Diamond Shores. So I believe the mobs in Diamond Shores drop some of the mats too, but I do farm Exelok and Sun Gold because it drops the epic parts, you know, like this, the little blue orby things and the purple eggs. That's just what I call them. I don't know what they're actually named. Yeah, so I'm using the Korean bow as well. This is a tier 3 with 258 DPS. That's a really, really terrible temper. I think I only got like a 1% temper or something, so it was kind of crap, and until the cash shop opens, you can't get these pyramid relics to undo the temper. So I'm stuck with this until I find an Aetherium bow. And I'm pretty broke, so getting an Aetherium bow to upgrade this is going to be a pain in my ass. Especially if I don't actually go and do stuff to make money instead of doing all these damn videos, but it's what it is. The rings and shit like that, I'm going to go to Carcassi. There's that spot here. Right up in here by the Red Dragon's Keep. There's like a little mat, a crafting table you can use to make these really cool armor penetration rings and some attack speed stuff or whatever you want. You can change it up how you want. It's just agility, and then you can change what you want on the passive effect. And all you need for that is the Red Dragon scales, and those just are randomly thrown about when the dragon gets spawned. And they're pretty cheap on the auction house, so if you want, you can just buy those. And you need a Artisan's Gale ring, which are going for around 50 to 60 gold right now. And then you need these Dragonbone ships here. you can farm these off of the scorpions here is the easiest I found, because they're melee, they're slow, and they're orange, so they don't attack you when you walk by, so you can kite through them and stuff, and it's pretty good. Alright, other than that, just regular gear that I've accumulated, I use the move speed cloak. I get more than enough attack speed out of Thwart. So, I'm using some Lustrous Squall, some random purples, and then some the Aurora pants, boots, and gloves, which I really like and I'm going to keep for a while until I get at least like a Ferium or Delphinad armor to replace them with, because the passives are so good. The flute I got from Greater Howling Abyss quest, just outside the door in the little tents. And then, I mean, that's about it. Can't really think of anything else before I start rambling. I just want to say thanks to people who are subscribing, liking, and commenting positive comments on my videos. It really is motivating me to make more videos. If you're one of those trolls that likes to dislike or downvote my comments or whatever just because I'm bushy or because you don't like me or you don't like primevals or some primeval just killed you and you're pissed off at him, well, I'm going to do my best to ignore you instead of lowering myself to your level, which I kind of did this last weekend or this last week. So I'm gonna work on that, not listening to the retards, and just wanted to thank you guys again if you're actually one of the positive people that contribute to my videos. Other than that, if you guys have any questions or, you know, want to do some PvP or arenas or whatever, or just want to say hi, you can hit me up anytime. sorry. Yeah, I mean, I'm not against helping people or, you know, just chilling with people. I really have no qualms about it, so. Anyways, until my next video, I will catch you guys later.